What happens when the city that never sleeps starts to run out of supplies? In the heart of the country's busiest transport hubs, an unusual quiet is descending. The New York City trucker boycott, initially dismissed as a fleeting protest, has been steadily gaining momentum. It's a movement that has shifted gears into a significant force, leaving an undeniable impact on the city's bustling highways. The New Jersey Turnpike, a lifeline for the city's supply chain, is a stark example of this change. Once a highway pulsating with the rumble of freight trucks, it's now experiencing an unexpected calm. The usual convoy of 18-wheelers has dwindled, their absence felt in the eerie silence that's replaced the familiar drone of engines. This isn't a case of fewer trucks on the roads, but rather a case of a mismatch in supply and demand within the trucking industry. The loads are there, waiting to be moved. They're piled high in warehouses, stacked on docks, and sitting in distribution centers, but the drivers, the vital link in this chain, are in short supply. The numbers speak for themselves. While 80% of truckers continue to navigate the city's notorious traffic, an important 20% are steering clear, choosing to participate in the boycott. This may not seem like a significant number at first glance, but it's enough to send ripples through the industry. Each truck that's not on the road means a load that's not delivered, a store that's not restocked, a production line that's halted. It's a domino effect that starts on the highway and ends up impacting the city's economy and its residents. The reasons behind the boycott are many. Toll increases, the fallout from the Trump case, and the struggles with low profit margins. But the result is the same. Fewer drivers are willing to make the journey into New York City. This is leading to higher prices, which are ultimately passed on to the consumers. As we see, 20% of truckers avoiding the city is enough to cause a noticeable impact. But why are these truckers boycotting New York City deliveries, you may ask? Well, it's a confluence of factors, and it all starts with an increase in tolls. The New Jersey Turnpike, a critical artery for trucking into the city, has seen a substantial hike in toll prices. This increase, while seemingly small, adds up when you're making multiple trips a day, every day of the week. Then there's the highly publicized Trump case. A prominent trucker known as Chicago Ray initially called for a boycott of deliveries to the city in response to a civil fraud judgment against the former president. This call resonated with a significant portion of truckers, many of whom are staunch supporters of Trump. Although Chicago Ray later retracted his statement, the seed had already been sown, and the boycott gained momentum. The third factor at play here is the issue of low profit margins. Trucking in general operates on razor-thin margins, and delivering to New York City is no exception. In fact, it's even worse due to the city's high cost of living and operating. Truckers are finding it increasingly difficult to turn a profit, and many are choosing to avoid the city altogether. These factors have collectively contributed to the growing unpopularity of trucking to New York City. With fewer drivers willing to make the trip, the supply-demand balance in the trucking industry is skewed. This imbalance leads to higher prices for the remaining available loads, and these costs are ultimately passed on to consumers. To put it in perspective, while 80% of truckers are still delivering to the city, a substantial 20% are participating in the boycott. This number may not seem like much, but when you consider the sheer volume of goods that need to be transported daily, it's a significant percentage. With these pressures mounting, it's no surprise that many truckers are choosing to avoid the city. So, what are the consequences of this boycott for the city that never sleeps? Well, let's dive into that. Think of the trucking industry as a vital lifeline, pumping the lifeblood of goods and services into the heart of the city. When this lifeline is choked off, even by just 20%, it starts to affect the pulse of the city. Picture this. You walk into your local grocery store expecting to pick up your regular items, only to find the shelves are sparse. This isn't due to a sudden surge in demand, but rather a drop in supply. The truck that usually delivers your favorite items is absent, parked in solidarity with the boycott. Now extend this scenario to other sectors. Construction sites waiting on materials, restaurants missing key ingredients, retail stores with dwindling stocks. It's a ripple effect that touches every corner of the city's economy, but it doesn't stop there. As supply drops, prices inevitably rise. It's a simple case of supply and demand. With fewer goods making it into the city, the cost of those goods goes up. This isn't just an issue for businesses, but for consumers too. Your weekly grocery bill could suddenly become more expensive, putting a strain on household budgets. And what about the city's reaction? Well, city officials are scrambling to find solutions. After all, New York City thrives on its bustling economy, and any disruption to that rhythm can have long-term impacts. Businesses are feeling the strain too, with some smaller enterprises struggling to stay afloat amidst these challenging times. As the boycott continues, the city is feeling the squeeze, and the end is nowhere in sight. But what does the future hold for New York City and its truckers? Let's take a moment to reflect on what we've discussed. The New York City trucker boycott has gained momentum, making a noticeable impact on the New Jersey Turnpike. With 20% of truckers participating in the boycott, the imbalance in the trucking industry is palpable, leading to more available loads than truck drivers willing to pick them up. Potential solutions to this quandary could involve negotiations between truckers and city officials, changes in toll policies, or even legal outcomes in the Trump case. Each of these options presents its own set of challenges and opportunities. It's also critical to consider the potential impacts if the boycott continues. Could we see a shift in the industry with smaller cities becoming new hubs for freight delivery? Or perhaps the advent of new technologies to fill the gap? The future is uncertain, yet filled with possibilities. As the road ahead unfolds, the resilience and adaptability of the trucking community will be put to the test. Only time will tell if the city and its truckers can find a way forward, or if the silent highways will become a permanent fixture of New York City life.